a thought into your hearing, something just to encourage you this day. I hope all is well. But what I want to talk to you today about is perception and deception. Perception and deception. Now, deception, we know, is to be deceived. Something that you thought that was a certain way, but in the end, you realize that it wasn't that at all. But now, let's start at perception. Perception is the image, how it looks, how things look. And if you notice that there are a lot of people who even have issues with trust, it's because of something that was perceived to look a certain way or to become a certain way. But in the end, it wasn't that way at all. Now, look at this. During the time of Adam and Eve, when God planted them in the garden, the Bible says that the serpent came to the woman. He was the most subtle beast of the field. And the thing that he did was he came to her and he began to talk to her. The Bible said he beguiled her. In other words, he got inside her head and deceived her, tricked her. And see, the thing about it with perception is not necessarily with your natural eyes, but perception also is with your spiritual eyes, where you understand something. And see, but the thing about it, what the serpent did when he was talking to that woman, but what he sold her was the power of suggestion, a subliminal thought. In other words, that subliminal thought, it looked good, it sounded good, but in it was a twist. And see, that's what the adversary will do, even through perception, something that looks good, it will have a twist. That's just like with an apple that has been injected with poison. The apple looks good, but when you eat the apple, after a while, 23 seconds, once your blood circulates, then the poison will kick in. And then, you know, your body will take a certain course. And so, see, but that's what the devil does. The Bible says he's an angel of light. Angel, that means that to perceive, the perception of. But then when he's a devouring, raging wolf. And so, but his job is to put the subliminal thought, to sell an idea, which is a seed. And the moment you begin to entertain that seed, then that's when it got you. Then you become deceived, because what it is that even the book said it'd be sweet to your lips, but then bitter to your stomach. And see, that's what the devil wants. He wants your lips to be sweet. He wants your lips to be sweet, but he wants your stomach to be bitter and rotten. And he wants to kill you. That's what he wants to do. And so, you know, it's crazy because even in the book of Matthew, where it talks about the sword of wheat and the tare, it was two things that was happening. There was a man that planted good seeds, but then when he went to sleep, the enemy came in and sowed bad tares. Now, tares, they look like wheat. You can't tell the difference. And see, the devil, what he wants to do, he wants to confuse you. He wants to make you think that it's real, but really it's fake. But the Bible says that you'll know a tree by the fruit it bears. Good tree can't bear bad fruit, and a bad tree cannot bear good fruit. So perception, that means to perceive, how you understand, how you see something, how you process something. And so that's why the Bible tells us to be careful for nothing. In other words, don't be in a rush. Don't be in a rush to understand. Don't be in a rush to move. But take time. Just give it time. Give things time that you're uncertain about a person. You're uncertain about a certain thing. The answer is time. And time will reveal to you its true colors. Because every tree is going to bear some type of fruit. And you'll be able to pick from it. If you can't pick good stuff from a person's life, then they're not of God. That's what the Bible says. So perception. And see, the thing about that we realize too, in this day and time, it seems like everybody is based on, they like to do things as a perception. I've even was told that, you know, and which is true, the package oftentimes is just as important as the inside. But if you get to the package and the package look good, but on the inside ain't nothing there, then that's no good either. So, you know, deal with and look for people who have substance. That means the fruit of their life, their behavior. Look for their behavior, a lifestyle, to see if that behavior is gratifying based on the Bible. Perception. Don't be perceived by your opinions. See, also, the devil will use your emotions, because, you know, you're praying for a certain thing, a certain guy, woman, or whatever, but then when you think they come, then that subliminal thought, oh, that's them. That's the perception. And once you entertain that, then that seed is planted. And if the person is deceiving you, then you will be hurt in the end. But keep your eyes open. That's why the Bible tells us to watch as well as pray. But don't let the adversary taint you from believing God. Don't let them taint you. You'll know the tree by the fruit it bears. That means not to try or not to give up. Even when you think something is of God, but the fear of, oh, the bad thing might happen again. No, don't live that way. We don't live that way. We live by faith. And see, the devil always will, in most cases, sell a counterfeit before the authentic come. But it's our job to identify and notice and watch for and discern what's of God and not of God. When you got the Spirit of God, you should know. Amen. Deception and perception. Perception and deception. God bless you.